Tell us about the recent encounter you had from a very disturbing video that we're going to look at first, and give us your reaction.
The issue here is that the current occupation of the Palestinian land by the Zionists have violated the human rights of the Palestinians. They have deprived the Palestinians of natural resources, such as water, and taking the majority of it for themselves.
Last summer, my son took a summer school class in the public school system, and I came home one day. He said to me, "Mom, you have to see this video. We're given an assignment about the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. Watch this." He pressed play, and there was this child basically talking about the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. He was somewhere between the age of 11 and 14. He was of Middle Eastern descent, and he was talking about the horrible Israelis and how they're depriving the Palestinians of water and natural resources. He went on to talk about, you know, the Zionists and their violent war crimes. What was really disturbing about this video was that there was no two sides of the narrative presented in this video. There was just one kid talking about clearly, you know, a very biased perspective on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. So I was shocked at this video. I said, how is this child, you know, age 11 to 13, the teacher to the children about the conflict?
Tell us how you're taking action and leading the charge through a new initiative called United Grassroots Movement.
Last summer, when this incident happened with me in the video, I decided, wow, this is really disturbing. I have to get involved in some activism for Israel and activism against anti-Semitism happening here in Toronto. So I joined a Facebook group called Everything Jewish Toronto that was started by this woman named Brittany Sultan and her sister. And I discovered this incredible group of people that were doing activism for Israel, but we were all individually doing activism. It's not only activism for Israel, it's activism against anti-Semitism. And one of the women, Agnes Imani, in this group started, she saw how all these individuals were doing their own independent activism, you know, volunteers getting involved in the community, and decided that she wanted to unite everybody together under one organization. So she named it United Grassroots Movement. It's an independent, not-for-profit organization. The organization is made up of all volunteers, and it's an incredible organization because we're not getting paid to do this work. We are just citizens, you know, here in Canada, members of the Toronto Jewish community, as well as members in the community that in the organization that are not Jewish, who are very concerned about this sudden spark and rise of anti-Semitism. So Agnes would like to invite people from all over the world to check out the organization, United Grassroots Movement, and see how our community has binded together to work together to fight this situation. And hopefully in other cities around the world, they'll join our organization and get involved, because it shows how you as an individual can really work on fighting the cause.
Due to the escalations and violence against Jews, you see more cases of people from North America who want to immigrate to Israel.
Most of them are moving to Florida. So I'm hearing a lot more people because of the COVID situation that they want to move to Florida. But yeah, there's definitely a talk about when are we going to be ready to run to Israel. There's definitely that conversation going on.
Thank you both so much for your very valuable insight, and we will see you soon.